So we have seen the insertion of a node in a singly linked list. Now we'll see how to delete a node from a linked list. Okay, so this class is focusing mainly on deletion operation in singly linked list. Okay, so hope you remember this linked list which we have constructed in the previous using previous class concepts, that is insertion of a node in singly linked list. The same linked list I'm taking for deletion also. Okay, so this is a linked list on which we are going to work. As I told here, you have an head pointer. I don't have the tail pointer pointing to the last node, only the head pointer, right? And you can see the first node address is 6000, the data part is containing a value 10, and the next pointer points to a node which is stored in location 1000, that is 1. Okay, so hope this part is fully clear. So next up, first operation here I'm trying to do is deletion from head. Okay, what is the meaning of that? I'm going to delete the first node in the linked list. Okay, so that means what all steps you have to take, you have to do when you are deleting a node, that's a first node. Okay, so we have to preserve the head pointer, only then you can reach all other nodes in the linked list. Okay, so you can't directly go and tell, okay, delete head. No, if you directly tell delete head, then we have lost all the links to other nodes. Clear? Because the head pointer is now having the address of the next node. So if you delete this head pointer, this link to the remaining part of the linked list is cut. Okay, so in order to preserve the head pointer, we are using another temporary pointer. So first I am assigning temp equal to head. Okay, then I'm just moving the head to the head next node. Why? If I delete this node, who is the next first node? This will be the second node, will be the first node in the linked list, right? So head pointer should point to the new first node. So I'm just taking head, move one step further, and it points to this node, that is a node containing data value 1, and then I am deleting the temp. Okay, so that's a sequence of the steps that you have to do for deleting the head node. Okay, so line 1, I have assigned temp equal to head. Now what is the result? Temp and head are pointing to the node at address 6000. Okay, you can see the two pointers are pointing to the single node. Okay, then what is the next step? Next step is head is moved to the next. So you can see in the previous slide, head was pointing to the same, head and temp was pointing to the same node, that is at the location 6000. Now head is jumped to the next node. Okay, next what you have done, delete this temp. Okay, so I have established the link, right? I have just deleted this node, and by preserving other part of the linked list. Okay, still head is pointing to the first node in the linked list. So your final linked list will be after deletion of the first node. So this node which contained value 10 is deleted, and the new node, the new first node, is with the value 1. Okay, so hope the steps are clear. Just you have to focus on the pointer reassignment by preserving. You have to check whether are you able to preserve the head pointer, or at any point are you missing any connection with the linked list. Okay, so the pointer reassignment part you have to take care of while doing operations in the linked list. Clear? So what is the time complexity of this operation? Yes, only you have to do three steps. Okay, or each of the steps are taking constant amount of time. So it is O of 1. clear. So again, you have to take care of the exceptions. Okay, if you have only one node in the linked list. Now we have how many nodes? 8 nodes, right? So from 8 nodes, you have deleted one node, so you got the 7 nodes. Okay, assume that you had only one node. What will be the deletion? That one node is pointed by head. So what you have to do? Can you do head is equal to head dot next? No, right? Head dot next is having the value null. Clear. So if there is only single node and you are invoking the function to delete a node from the head, that means you have to set head is equal to null. That means head is not pointing to any linked list or the linked list is empty. Clear. Another exception is there is no linked list build at all and you are trying to do a deletion operation. Then you will be checking if head is equal to null, then the linked list is not constructed. So again, so these exception cases are to be filled by you. Is it clear? Okay. So I have shown you the steps for deleting a node from the head of a linked list, singly linked list. Okay. So if there is a single node, how will be the step? If there is no node in the linked list, how will you do the, what steps you have to take care of? Please try to find out, okay? Operation 2. So that is deletion from tail, okay? So that means I have to delete the last element in the linked list, clear? So if I need to delete the last element in the linked list, then I have to reach this node, right? I have to reach this node. I have only the head pointer, right? So I have to reach this node. Then only you can do the operation. Clear. So here what you have to do is, I'm just assigning a temp. You can see the steps over here, which is in yellow color, right? So I have done a traversal step, which will take the temp pointer to this node. Okay, I'll explain that in this traversal in the next slide. Once you reach this node, then you have to do the subsequent pointer reassignment steps. So let's see how is this deletion operation done. Okay, so the first line is temp is equal to head. So now temp and head are pointing to the same node or the first node. Next, what is the condition checking of the for loop? Condition checking is temp dot next dot next. Okay, it is not temp dot next, it is temp dot next not equal to null. Okay, in this case, so you can see, we'll see how the traversal is done. Temp dot next is 2000, dot next is, sorry, dot next is this 8000. That means what? It is not equal to null. Clear? So temp dot next is this, dot next is this node. Clear? So this node's next is not equal to null. So what you have to do? You have to enter the for loop. But this for loop is a do nothing for loop. You can see a semicolon at the end. So if it is a do nothing for loop, then it will go to the incrementation step. Incrementation is temp equal to temp dot next. So it is just pointing, it is just jumping to the next node in the linked list. Now it is after the first iteration of the for loop, temp will be pointing to this node. Okay, that is the node with the value 2. Now what is again the condition checking is temp dot next is 8000. Its next is 3000, okay, which is not equal to null. So what you have to do, again temp equal to temp dot next, so temp is pointing to this node which contains value 50. Okay, next what you have done here, I'll be checking temp dot next is 3000, dot next is 4000, which is not equal to null. So temp is pointing to this node. Temp is equal to temp dot next. Now from here I am checking temp dot next dot next. temp dot next is 4000, dot next is 5000, which is not equal to null. So temp is moved to the one more pointer, that is this node. Okay, now with reference to this node, I'll check temp dot next is 5000, dot next is 7000, which is not equal to null. So temp is moved to this point, this node. Okay, here again I'm checking temp dot next is 7000, dot next is equal to null. Now what happens? This condition is false now, right? I need to check not equal to null, but now it is equal to null. So what you have to do? The condition is false, so it exits a for loop. So when the for loop is exited, temp will be pointing to the second last node in the linked list. Okay, because if we are pointing to this node, that's the last node, and if we remove this, we can't reach this node in order to set this value as none. Okay, clear. So what we are trying to do, we are stopping at the second last node and try to do the deletion of the last node. Clear. So after execution of the for loop, the linked list, the state of the linked list will be like this. Temp will be pointing to the second last node in the linked list. And then what you have done, delete temp dot next. So what is done here? Temp dot next is 7000. So in the location 7000, what is the node? That is deleted. Okay. And what is one more step? You need to mark the end of the linked list, right? So earlier this node was pointing to 7000, which I have to make it as null. Okay. So that assignment is pending. So what you have done? Temp dot next is equal to null. So this is a pointer assignment you have done. So earlier it was 7000. Now you are making it as null. Clear. So then final linked list after deletion of the last node is this. Okay. So what is the time complexity of whole of this steps for deleting the last node? Yeah, it is big O of n. Provided you have only the head pointer. Okay, again, if there is a tail pointer, then you have to do a different logic. Clear. Here in the linked list, we have only the head pointer, so I have to traverse the linked list to reach the last node, and then I have to delete. So the traversal time complexity will become, you have to traverse all the nodes, so it is O of big O of n. Now next operation is deleting any specific node or any random node in the linked list. Okay, so let us try deleting the node with value 50, this one. So what you have to do, reach the node before this node which contains 50, right? That means I have to reach this node, that is the node which contains value 2. And what you have to do next, you have to set this pointer's address as what? This node, right? That means this link, that is the link between node containing 2 and 50, has to be broken, and it has to be redirected to the node after 50. So if I want to take this link to point to this node, the address of this node is available in the node which I am going to delete. Yes, hope you are clear what I am trying to tell. Okay, I'll repeat it once again. I am stopping at the node just before the node which I want to delete. Okay, now I am pointing to this node. After that, what I am trying to do is I want to delete this node. That means this link, I have to break this link and create a new link between these two nodes, right? Between 2 and 3. But where is the address of the node which contains 3? The address of the node which contains 3 is available in the node which I am going to delete. Clear. So that pointer reassignments we have to do as a second step after reaching the node which I am trying to delete. So hope you are clear with the traversal part for deleting any specific node in the linked list. Okay, so we'll proceed with this two steps. Okay, so what is this? The step one, traverse the linked list to reach the node which is the node before the node that I want to delete. Okay, so I want to reach this node. Now what I'm trying to do here is you can see the line number one in our logic. You can see an for loop which I'm using for traversing. So initially temp is set to head. So temp and head are pointing to the first node in the linked list. Next, what I'm doing is searching for the node 50. Okay, so I have to stop traversing just before the node which contains 50. So what is the idea here is temp dot next dot data. That means in the first case, temp dot next is 2000. In 2000 location, what is the data? It is 2. So 2 not equal to 50. Okay, so the condition is true. If it is true, what you are doing? Temp equal to temp dot next. So now temp will point to this node, right? The node containing 2. Okay, now again I'll iterate for the next iteration. What I'm doing, temp dot next, that is 8000, dot data, that is 50. So 50 not equal to 50. So condition is what? False. If condition is false, I will exit. Okay, so is this loop clear? Now here I have an exception here. Okay, what if my temp dot next is equal to null? Then I don't have a data part. Clear? Hope you understood the point. I'm checking temp dot next. Okay, if temp dot next is equal to null, what is the meaning? I have only one node, right? So I can't go to the data part. Clear? So what is the condition I am doing here? In the next slide you can see temp dot next not equal to null, right? Temp dot next is 2000 and it is not equal to null, and temp dot next dot data not equal to 50. Okay, you can see a combined boolean expression for condition checking here. Okay, temp dot next not equal to null and temp dot next dot data not equal to 50. So two conditions are, if both the conditions are true, then only you will iterate the loop. Okay, so temp dot next not equal to null, okay, condition is true, and temp dot next dot data, that is 2 not equal to 50, so condition is true. So temp equal to temp null. Next, what you are doing is temp dot next not equal to null, yes, condition is true, and you are checking temp dot next dot data not equal to 50. So it is false. So true and false is false. So it exits a loop and temp stays at this point. Hope I am clear with this for loop. Okay, so I have highlighted the condition here. Hope it is clear. Temp dot next not equal to null, why I have combined these two conditions. Clear? Okay, now after traversing this or after executing this for loop, what will be the status of my linked list? Temp will be pointing to the node which contains, just before the node which contains 50. That means temp is pointing to this node. Okay, now what is the next step we have? We are setting a pointer here which is pointing to the next node of the temp. That means the node which I want to delete. It is pointed by cut. Okay, the name of the pointer here I am using for delete the node which I want to delete is cut. So cut equal to temp dot next. So when I execute the statement, this will be the snapshot of the linked list. Okay, I'm setting a pointer which points to the node which I want to delete. Next, what is an I want to reassign this address, right? This address has to be set to the this address. So where is this 3000 available? 3000 is there in the node which I want to delete. So what is the pointer reassignment? You can see temp dot next, that means this 8000 is equal to cut dot next. What is cut dot next? 3000. Okay, so now 8000 will be replaced by or assigned by 3000. Okay, so you can see this dotted link, which is a new link that is established via this assignment. Okay, so now a quick question. So here we did temp dot next is equal to cut dot next. Instead of that, can I do temp dot next is equal to temp dot next dot next, provided these conditions are not equal to null. Okay, that means temp dot next is not equal to null, temp dot next is also not equal to null. Okay, so there is no exceptions here now. So assume that these two conditions are not giving any exceptions. Is this statement can be replaced by this statement? Okay, so just think about that and write it in your notebook. Okay, so continuing with the line number 4. Now I have established this link, though. So 8000 is now reassigned to 3000. That means I have taken this link, and now I am deleting this node, which is cut. Okay, so final linked list will be this. Clear? So we started with the same linked list here, right? In the first class, we started with the linked list which contains five elements or five nodes. Okay, and then we inserted three nodes in the last class, right? One at the beginning, one at the tail, and one at a random position. The nodes which we have inserted in the first class is deleted in this video. Okay, and now we are back to our linked list which we have started with. Okay, so what will be the time complexity of the operations? Yes, so the deletion of any random position, the worst case can be if you are asking to delete the last node, then it becomes O of N, right? So any random position also, we can tell that the time complexity of worst case is big O of N.